Silence
is gold.
Oh, the person that's talking to you is going to want to hear you say something bad, too, I'm telling you.
Yeah,
what is it they say, birds of a feather flock together?
Not together.
So if one speaking evil of somebody else, they're going to try to probe you, you know, what they think and how they feel. But remember what the Bible says about whispers separating chiefest of friends.
Yeah.
You know, you hear enough bad and 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 enough bad about Mayor Brooke Jackson, Sandra, whoever. After a while, you're going to think bad.
Yeah, that's the truth.
And it might not even be true.
Right.
I found out before, there's things, Brother George, I thought for a fact, believed him, come find out it wasn't true after all.
You're exactly right. Amen.
Don't y'all let me lose anointing this morning.
Come on, brother.
Well, I know. Y'all ain't got nothing to do with it. Praise the Lord. The Lord has. But you know what I'm saying?
Come on.
James chapter 3, verse 6 says, and the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. So is the tongue among our members that it defiles the whole body.
Yep.
Did you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
The tongue not only hurts the mouth, but it don't only hurt the arm or the leg or the toe, it defileth the whole body.
Yep, it does.
And setteth on fire the course of nature, and is set on fire of hell. Listen to what it says. I believe God's telling us sometimes we need to. Because that's one of the biggest things the devil loves to use for division.
Yep.
Is this right here, this little member that can't seem to be controlled.
Amen.
I'm going to read the... Where is it?
Bless them, Lord.
For every kind of beast and bird and serpents and tame and deceased tame and have been tamed to mankind, but the tongue can no man tame. It is an unruly evil full of deadly poison.
Yes.
The tongue is full of deadly poison. Therewith we bless God the Father, and therewith we curse men, which are made after the image of God.
Yes.
Out of the same mouth proceeded blessing and cursing. Then, my brethren, these things ought not so to be. Can a fountain send forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? Can a fig tree bring forth olive berries? Can a vine, either can vine figs, so can no fountain both yield salt water and fresh.
Amen. Really.
So if there's some salt water in there and you don't want to get it mixed up, get it out.
Yes. Rid of
Praise
it.
The Lord. Did you hear what I was saying, church? Go with me to a place that I know every one of you can probably quote with me. Proverbs. Where am I going, sisters? Andrew, you already know, don't you? You really know it. Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter 6. Chapter 6, verse 16, I'm sorry. Anybody getting anything out of this morning?
Come on. Man.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Good stuff.
Good stuff.
God loves
you. Come on, brother.
He loves us. He loves this body. He wants this body to be unified. And He wants no division here because He's got something He's about to do.
Yes.
Before I read this, I want to tell you something. I didn't fight in the Vietnam War. But I always watch movies about it, Brother Derek. Don't know a whole lot about it. But I do know this. Our country was divided over that situation. Our nation was divided, you know, had different issues concerning that particular engagement. And I know that, and some of you might see it differently, but I feel like we sort of lost that one a little bit. I mean, I watched a kind of a documentary about it, to the best of my understanding, which I ain't the smartest person in the world, but to the best of my understanding, it looked almost like we were running out of that place. The greatest nation in the world. Now, I'm telling you this for a reason. Just don't lose me just yet. The reason I said that is because we may be advanced in weaponry. We may have been advanced in technology. We may have been advanced in a lot of things, but those little folks had something that we needed more of.
Yeah.
Unity.
Yeah.
There was, I know there was times, you know, they come together, Brother George.
Yep.
They come together. They come together in unity without division. I watched one movie one time where all the high command would, ever so often, they would get into this area and they would go to a certain place over this side. And all the soldiers, the footmen, the riflemen, whatever, they would be over here on the other side. And I guess they figured it out, Brother Derek. And the next thing you know, they come in there and they split them.
Yeah.
Where the command couldn't get to the regular infantry. They divided them, Sister Sandra. And they won that particular battle because they were able to bring the division. I'm talking about division this morning, sir. I know I'm trying to get it in a way to help you understand we have to come together where there is no division, where there's unity. I don't know anything about history or about Custer or about whoever he was. What was that Indian's name? What was his name?
I don't know.
Was it Little Bighorn? Where that Custer? Where that battle was? I don't know. Was it
Little Bighorn?
Little Bighorn and
Sitting Bull. Sitting Bull.
What Geronimo? I was thinking Geronimo. But anyway, I don't know nothing. I don't know what happened. I just know that Custer didn't win that battle. That's it. That's all I know about that. But I've wondered, Sister Sandra. You know, the devil brings confusion a lot of times.
Yep.
And if he can bring confusion and division, he's done got half the battle already, Brother Derek, at the get-go. But I just wonder. I bet that was a pretty smart guy. You know, because, and I just wonder sometimes how much confusion there was going on and when all this battle was taken. Custer was he's a great general from my understanding.
Yeah, he was.
But he lost the battle to someone that had less technology. Someone that was supposed to not have as much wits and smarts. But you know what he did? I believe he used some wits and smart. And I believe he realized if we can just bring confusion into the camp, maybe. I'm not saying that. I don't know nothing about it. I'm just saying that I know that confusion and division will bring about failure. If we can just keep together, Sister Sandra, and not be divided. See, there's always going to be, you know, none of us are perfect. There may be times you hear something about me that you didn't like. You know what? The best thing to do is pray for me.
Amen.
Because there have been times that I've had to say, God, somebody else, Brother Derek, is more worthy. God, why do you want me to do it? Because even though I might have stumbled, erred, faltered, failed, sinned, see, God knew my heart. And when the Holy Spirit pricked my heart, and when he touched me, and he said, son, I love you, but this ain't right. This is wrong. And I felt him come over me, Sister Sandra, and he pulled me back to my knees, and the tears began to come. And I cried out to him and said, Father, I failed you. I have sinned against you. God, have mercy on me. And Lord, forgive me. When I meant that with all my heart, Sister Shirley, and had no intentions ever again of doing the same thing, guess what?
He did.
God's grace and God's mercy. Even though I was unworthy, Brother George.
Yes.
Came through again.
Yes, you did,
baby. Praise the Lord. You've had to have that same grace.
Yep.
You've had to have that same mercy. But we've got to come together this morning. If you know of a brother that's failed, pray for him. God can restore.
Man.
You know, if you see me down in a hole, and I've been walking through a field, and I fell in a hole that I didn't know was there, I broke my leg. And I can't get out. And I'm hollering.
Yeah.
I've fallen. I've failed. I've stumbled. I'm broken.
Come on.
And you pass by me. And I say, Sister Sandra, can you give me a hand?
Yeah.
Or Brother Derek, can you give me a hand? Or Brother John, can you give me a hand? Or Sister Diane, can you give me a hand? And you look at me and say, you know better than to fall in a hole. You know better than to walk there.
Come on.
You fell in the hole. No, you're going to reach down if you love me. And you're going to say, come on, brother, let me help you. And you're going to try to get me out of there as carefully and easily as you possibly can.
Right.
Because you care about me.
Amen.
Come on, brother.
Then you, right. I'm going to preach it anyway.
Come on.
I'm going to preach it anyway. Praise the Lord. I don't know everything, but neither do you. But God knows everything.
Yeah.
And He knows the truth. tricks of the devil. And he knows what the devil's up to. And he knows that the devil would love to bring division into this body.
Amen. Yes.
You heard the Lord through Sister Sandra this morning. She was highly anointed, y'all believe it or not.
Amen.
And she said, I know this sounds hard, but I'm anointed by the Holy Ghost. It wasn't her saying it. God was just using her lips and her voice.
Amen.
She was in unity with the Spirit of God.
That's right.
She was in contact with the one that knew what we needed and what was going on and what the devil was up to. See, we can't always see what's going on in the spiritual world, but God knows what the devil's up to. I got to say that again. I said that God knows what the devil's up to, and the devil wants to hurt us, y'all. Just in case you ain't figured it out yet, he ain't your buddy. He ain't your friend, and he don't like you.
Right.
I've had him come to me since I've had problems with my back. And he said, you know, you prayed. He said, you know, you even went to a chiropractor. You know, you even went to see the doctor to therapy. It ain't gone. But I can probably just take it away for you if you'll just ask me.
Mm-hmm.
You say, no, he didn't say that. Yes, he did. Yes, he did. And I said, if that be the case, I just have to hurt until God decides to take it away.
Yep.
He's the Lord.
Amen.
He's God alone. He is Alpha and Omega.
Yes,
the first and the last, the beginning and the end, and there is no in between.
He tore that wall down.
He is God.
Yes, he did.
Let me say it again, church. I said, he's God.
Yes.
And he knows what's going on. And listen to what I'm saying. And I'll say this, and y'all, there'll be people that ain't even in here this morning that'll come to you, and you'll hear some gossip.
Yep.
It may be as soon as you go home or as soon as you get out of church.
Come on.
You might hear some gossip. It may be about me or Sister LaVonne, about Brother Derek, Sister Sandra.
Yep.
Come on.
Brother Hines. The devil don't care who he smears over. So what you gonna do? Tomorrow on your job, you may hear something bad about somebody. What you gonna do? Backbiting doesn't seem. Yeah, Sister Sandra said it this morning. The small fox spoils the vine.
Yeah.
It don't take but a little bitty thing. It don't take nothing but one match to burn the woods down.
Yeah.
One little bitty fire.
Yeah.
One little bitty word. One little bitty thought that you'll allow to come through your mind and go right out your mouth.
Yeah.
That's all it takes. The devil knows that. I'm going to just go ahead and tell you, the devil wants to take us down, y'all. He wants to take us down, and I'll tell you what his plan is. How do you know that? Because I know what God's saying this morning. He's going to try to use division. He's going to try to separate us. He's going to try to bring forth confusion between us. Well, I just don't know what to do. I don't know what to think about it. I'll tell you what to think about it. Let God tell you about it. If you have an ought against me, take it to God. If I'm not where I'm supposed to be and you're where you're supposed to be, God will tell you what my problem is.
Yeah.
And then we both can get me fixed.
Amen.
If God's got you fixed, you can help fix me.
Amen.
But if you're going to talk and backbite and put me down and say all the manners of evil against me, you ain't quite where you need to be yet either.
Amen.
Or you wouldn't be talking about me, so we both still in the same boat, ain't we?
Yeah.
The only way you'd be in a different boat is if you was praying for me and God told you what the problem was and you come to me and told me and I'm willing to repent of it.
Yep.
Just like Sister Sandra did one time. I don't even put you on the spot, Sister, but that helped me. I don't even know if you remember or not. She come up here, whatever it was, I don't remember. But she told me, and I felt the Spirit of God bring my heart down on my face. I went, I don't know if y'all remember, and I found the floor. God, I'm sorry, Lord, forgive me, because I have sinned.
Amen, brother.
No, you ain't supposed to sin. No, I'm not. That's why I'm supposed to strive to be perfect, isn't it? Bible says in one place that if any man sin, you know what I always thought about that scripture?